Our last piece from Felix Mendelssohn is actually one of the most famous and the one of the most performed. It is called A Violin Concerto in E Minor. And it was the last piece that he composed before he became ill. He had taken up residence as the principal conductor of the Leipzig Gewandhaus Orchestra. And he had a melody that he just simply couldn't get out of his head. So what did he decide to do? Bring in the reinforcements. He sent a note to a childhood friend called Ferdinand David, who was a virtuoso violinist. And on this letter he wrote, "I should like to write a violin concerto for you next winter. One in E minor runs through my head, the beginning of which gives me no peace." And thus began 6 years of collaboration between the two. Felix often ran his ideas by Ferdinand because Ferdinand was the perfect person for the job, because Ferdinand would often be playing a lot of Felix's compositions. And so he could give him very timely and relevant feedback in regards to his pieces. One question people were asking though is, why did this piece take so long? Was it that Felix entered a period of self-doubt? Did he have other projects that he needed to focus on? We don't really know the answer, but the point is, this was really unlike the brilliant mind of Felix Mendelssohn. In 1845, Violin Concerto in E minor was premiered, but sadly, Felix Mendelssohn was unable to conduct this piece himself because he became ill. And this was the beginning of what would be a constant subsequent event of illnesses that would later lead to his demise. His life was coming to a close, and a few years later, he plunged into a deep state of depression as his creative partner in crime, his sister Fanny, had passed away. He would later succumb to a subsequent series of strokes that eventually took his life at only 38 years of age. A Violin Concerto in E minor became one of his most famous pieces and is actually considered a rite of passage for any violinist that wants to go up a level. It is known as a stamp of approval for any violinist that can play it, mainly because of the technical expertise that's needed in order to be able to handle and perform this piece. The opening strains of it actually sounds like an escape from perilous danger. A lot of people often ask, what more would have Felix done for the Romantic era? What more would he have done for music at that time had he not passed away at such an early age? We are not sure and we will never know, but he did leave us with a huge collection of operas and symphonies and masterful works. So go ahead and listen to this rite of passage piece, A Violin Concerto in E minor.